Hey everybody, Jeremy here, welcome back to the channel. Owning your own home is the Australian dream, but with housing prices being up over 20% since the start of the pandemic, it is a seriously difficult time to buy. While me and my partner have successfully bought our first home in and amongst these unprecedented house prices. I seriously hate the word unprecedented. So today, I'm gonna take you through the four things that we did to help land our first home. Right now, there's just no deals available. Now for me, this was a really difficult one to get my head across because I love a bargain. Traditionally, houses are listed with a price bracket. Offer something within that price bracket and you'll get a look at the place. But that just isn't the case right now. Now it's about putting in an offer that you think is fair for the property. And yes, most of the time that means putting in an offer that's over the asking price for the house. While you can use previous sales guides in your suburb as a guide for what a house should go for, in reality, right now, you're putting in a number that you feel that you can live with and pretty well hoping for the best. For example, the first property that my partner and I wrote an offer on, we put an offer in $25,000 over asking. Now, this property certainly wasn't cheap by any means, and the offer I put in, I thought was well and truly on the upper end of fair. We missed out on that property by $100,000. How am I ever gonna buy a house? Whilst I guess we could have technically afforded that property, we would have had to have been out of our minds to pay that amount of money for that particular type of house in that suburb. But this isn't an isolated case by any means. Have a look at any real estate website and you'll see countless listings where the house has gone for well and truly above their listed asking price. This is great if you're selling a house, but absolutely terrible if you're looking to buy. And I'll add, very disheartening. So chances are you're probably gonna write a lot of offers and get blown out of the water most of the time. Now this is easier said than done, but you need to try and avoid overpaying as best you can. Now this is more important in traditionally slow growth markets such as Adelaide. And whilst in my opinion, you shouldn't be buying a house to live in as an investment, you should still be expecting to see a positive price growth over say a 5-year period. You need to make yourself an appealing purchaser. The key is to stand out from the crowd and not be like a Where's Wally book, hoping that someone can spot you amongst the chaos. In addition to having your number in the right ballpark, you need to be flexible. The seller, for instance, may want a really short or a really long settlement. If you're flexible and can work towards your seller's desires, that's an advantage. And this was something that was really important when we purchased our first home. In our particular circumstances, the vendor wanted a particular settlement date. And us being able to be flexible and accommodating that date was really key to our offer standing out. You also want to try, when possible, to avoid making your offer subject to a whole heap of things, particularly things like the sale of another property. Put yourself in the seller's shoes. If you had two offers that were extremely similar, but one was subject to a whole heap of conditions, which one do you think you're choosing? Sort your finances out now. If you need finance and you do not have full approval, do it now. You may have some idea of what you can borrow, but what you actually need to know is what you can actually borrow. You then need to decide how much you're willing to borrow and set yourself a hard limit. Now I know from experience, it's hard to walk away from a house that you like, but it's important that you do so if it's out of your financial means. Otherwise, that dream house isn't likely to be so dreamy and is probably gonna turn into a noose around your neck. And remember, there's a lot of hidden costs in buying and owning your own home. Make sure you have plenty of buffer in these expenses and have additional funds for hidden repairs or things like future rate rises. If you are looking at buying a house or refinancing, consider cheaper online lenders like Athena. Because online lenders have a lower overhead cost, some of the products they can offer are significantly cheaper than the likes of the big banks. For us personally, we went with Athena Home Loans and were able to get a sub 2% comparison rate with an offset account. Better still, if you sign up for a new loan or refinance through Athena using the code in the description below, you'll get $250 towards your mortgage. Say it with me, everybody. The agent is not my friend. The agent works for the seller. It is the agent's job to get the highest price possible for the vendor. And as most agents work on commission, they are very incentivized to do this. We found during most opens, agents were pretty nice. However, the market is very different to how it was, say, 2 years ago. In the current climate, it's extremely common to say have an open on a Saturday with offers closing on the Tuesday. Agents are also likely to only be calling people that have put offers on a property. Seemingly for now, gone are the days are an agent calling you a few days or even a few weeks after an open to see if you like the place. It's very much a mentality of, don't call us, we'll call you. And when they do call you, expect to hear, there are other offers. Is this your best offer? Now, this happened to us on every house we put offers on. And unfortunately, in the current climate, unless the house is going to auction, you really have no way of knowing where your offer sits. So my advice is stick to your guns. Only increase your offer if you think the house is worth the additional money and if you can afford to do so. Now, in our case, before we put our initial offer in, my partner and I had already discussed what our maximum was going to be if we eventually got asked for more cash. And in our case, we agreed we'd only increase our offer by $5,000. And if we happened to miss out on the property, well, so be it. So how did it work out for us? Well, we bought a 4-bedroom, double garage home on approximately 700 square meters in Adelaide's southern suburbs. Pre-pandemic, we probably could have bought a house in this area for $400,000 to $450,000. When we first looked at the house was listed at $498,000 to $548,000. That's a pretty spicy suburb increase. And we ended up paying a little bit over $580,000. But based on other sales in the area in the last couple of months, we've paid probably about market average, if not, dare I say, a fraction less. For us though, the house wasn't bought as an investment. It was bought as a house to live in. It does, however, have some low-hanging fruit in terms of renovations that we could do that would add significant value to the property. We justified our buying decision, however, because we were financially and emotionally ready to buy. In reality, you could probably argue we might have overpaid by about $20,000. But this was one of three houses of about the 100 my partner and I looked at that we both liked. And when we factored that we're on the hook for about another 24K in rent if we were to extend our lease by another 12 months, we kind of figured that the difference in the property price and the rent was kind of a wash. However, ultimately, it was something that we could easily afford to do. And that's what really drove our decision. And for that reason, we don't have any regrets. Speaking of regrets, so don't forget to get your free stock from Stake worth all the way up to $140 when you sign up below with the link in the description. Guys, I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say about the property market. Are you looking to buy at the moment? Have you been putting offers in? Are there any other tips and tricks that you can share with the audience that can help them land their first home? Chuck them down in the comments below. I'd love to see it. Well, guys, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, smash that like button. It really does help me out and I appreciate it tremendously. Till next time, take care.